Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and yet another braces video. This was actually a question that came in from one of my great doctors this week, and I realized I did not have any content around it. So you're never going to hear this concept anywhere else. Like if you Google this, decorative bracketing, I don't know what you're going to get. I literally made up this word. This is a word that I've been using for a very long time, but and I'm sure this concept is being used in other ortho offices and probably also in ortho residencies. They probably call it something different. So feel free in the comments section to say if you're familiar with this concept, what you call it, because I'd love to know, you know, what you guys call it. But I'm going to try my best to explain it. Keep in mind, this is a very advanced video. So unless you've either taken my straight wire course and my phase one course or watched all my straight wire playlists, this is not going to make any sense to you. So I'm going to use pretty advanced concepts and words very shortly. I'm going to switch. So I'm going to mention a few videos. I'm not trying to sell any courses. So I'm going to mention a few videos that I know are on my YouTube playlist that you can search for by keyword that you'll want to watch first in order to make this make sense. So obviously asking you to watch the whole straight wire playlist or take my course is like 15 hours, at least 20 hours, 30 hours. So a few videos that come to mind will be helpful. First of all, I want you to watch my anterior open bite videos. You can search by keyword. I want you to also watch my OMT videos, oral myofunctional therapist, acronym is OMT. Watch those videos because these all come into play. I want you to watch my video called BiMax, B-I-M-A-X, BiMax protrusion video, and make sure you watch those first, okay? So let's say hypothetically speaking, and you guys know that whenever I have a case with like, oh, also I want you to watch my Ceph videos, Ceph, cephalometric x-ray videos, the poll playlist. Okay, so let's say we have a case, it's BiMax, flared incisors, protrusive due to a tongue thrust or a habit that has been controlled, not according to the patient, but you actually had an OMT screen it and there is no more habit. Okay, this is important because if you guys do this wrong, I have a few doctors I'm working with right now that bypassed that important bit of information. They took the patient's word for it. Clearly the habit wasn't gone. I don't know if your habit is gone when I help you with your case. I mean, I'm gonna take your word on it. If you tell me the habit's gone, the habit's gone. You've done what you needed to do to double check. You cannot take the patient's word on this. And it's very difficult to screen in office unless you know what you are doing. Unless you have a team member who is OMT certified, you guys don't know what you're doing with this. And you are going, some of you guys have these cases right now and you guys are up against a wall. I told you not to do it. I told you to send the patient to OMT, but you're not doing it. So y'all are struggling with these cases and it's going to be impossible at this point. You're probably going to have to give a refund because you didn't follow directions. But anyways, just frustration because I preach this stuff about habits, like preach it all day long if you've worked with me, because it's happened to me. It's happened to every orthodontist. And you know what? This wasn't even that much of a thing 20, 30 years ago. Just we were like, sometimes I can't take this case. You know, now there's ways to control this. An oral myofunctional therapist is a therapist who specializes, it's like physical therapist, but they specialize in the teeth, the tongue, the mouth, oral habits, head position. I mean, all kind of stuff. So if you do not have external forces under control, your case won't get where you're supposed to get, or it's going to move unpredictably, or it's going to give weird or bad outcomes and you're going to be stuck. So let's start there. Let's assume that this flared BiMax anterior open bite case, okay, has been controlled. There's zero habits except for maybe mouth breathing, which still is a habit and needs to be controlled. You've also sent the patient to ENT if needed. You got the okay in writing from ENT to go ahead and begin. You've also done a sleep screening or a sleep test. I mean, there's a lot of hoops you need to go through before you even consider taking a case like this in an adult or a kid. A kid is easier because we can fix things a lot faster and undo habits a lot easier than an adult. An adult, this is probably going to be a surgical case. Most likely, although y'all are trying to attempt these cases and I'm laughing, you're gonna struggle if it even works out. So anyway, sorry, quick rant, but it's just blowing my mind. I've got so much videos about this, but you guys are not doing what you need to do. Okay, so all these dots have been dotted, the T's have been crossed, we're good to go. Let's say we decided to cut bait and either take out eighths or third molars and move this into Invisalign, or, well, we're talking about braces here, so take that out. We've decided to extract premolars, okay? I hate doing that, but occasionally you guys got to do it. It's not a kid. They're not growing. That's the only way we're going to close the spaces, or there's just a lot of spaces. What is decorative bracketing? And the patient really wants braces and not Invisalign, which is so much easier in Invisalign. Okay, so what's going to happen if you just throw braces in up here? Well, and tie everything in the way you're supposed to. You could potentially push the teeth through the bone. We don't want to do that. So I do something called decorative bracketing. Now, back in residency, we did two things with the situation. We didn't really do the decorative bracketing. What we would do is we would do segments. So we would only bond 3-6, 3-6, 3-6, 3-6. Posterior teeth only. We didn't bond the anterior teeth where the issue was. Or maybe like all lowers and then just back teeth on top. And then we would align segments, which means you're going to have to flame and cinch the wires. The wires can roll. It's a little tricky. And then we would retract on a heavy steel segment wire 3-6. Or we would, the other thing you can do is you can not bond these front teeth at all. And you can just bond the back teeth and just use a full wire, but put some type of tubing so it doesn't flex in the front. So it kind of looks like a retainer wire, like a Holly. The problem is what flew 20 years ago in terms of biomechanics and looking weird does not fly anymore. I mean, definitely with nowadays with Instagram and everything else, somebody's parents are going to complain about this. So it's just not going to work in a private practice situation. Maybe in a different country besides the US, maybe you can do that. So I came up with the idea of decorative bracketing. I'm not saying I came up with it. Other people probably do it too. Which is where if you do not engage all the wings, if you just engage two of the wings, you can still make it look nice. You can put on the other wing, you can put the tie under the wire. Okay, so you're only going to engage meaning the rubber band elastic goes over the wire and ties it in on one and two wings, not four wings, not the full mini twin. It's not that tight and it's really not doing much in that case. It's literally just decorative, you know, it just keeps the wire from flopping around. But it's not going to push the wire through the bone. So that is what decorative bracketing is. And you can use it on these type of cases. And then obviously on the back teeth, you're going to fully figure eight all these. You know, you're going to go to town on these back teeth, just on the teeth that are flared. You're not going to. So that's what that is. You can use it to your advantage if you have one of these hypothetical cases. Hopefully that was helpful. All right, thanks.